the booth where they you can't videotape some of the stuff I'm going to say tonight, just to let you know.
All right. Is this one that I shouldn't videotape?
No, this one's fine.
Now. Okay.
There's a sound cabinet. The way I heard it, the sound cabinet had a little speaker and had a whole bunch of toggle switches. And each toggle switch you could go through and could flip the toggle switch and you'd be able to hear all the different tracks in the ride and see if everything was playing properly. And that particular toggle was, everything was labeled numerically, but that toggle was labeled 69. It wasn't 63, 64, 65, 69, it was 32, 33, 69, 36.
Because it was a chick in the control thing and a guy was upside down.
Mm-hmm. And she was talking him into position. She was talking him into position.
Awesome. Oh,
it's almost in, honey, that kind of stuff. And they apparently went through, just like they did with Mickey's a Faggot, and turned the sound down on that one so that you could, the only way you could hear it clearly was to find that sound in the cabinet and throw that switch.
Well, we used to take our audio recorder in the Horizons and reach out and leave it and come back later and get it so we would have full loops of things. Yeah. And we got one real close to that. I'll have to listen to that again.
Yeah, that's insane. That's awesome.
Good.
Wow.
Wow.
He said, I'll send it back to you. So I'm taking it back.
That is so awesome. Cool.
How long were you the only Dreamfinder before they hired another guy that worked with you?
Not long. About maybe 5 or 6 months.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. The next guy was brought in was Steve Taylor. He's the one who did it for 15 years.
Mm-hmm.
Poor guy. Bad carpal tunnel syndrome.
Yeah, I had bad days from working a little.
I went through some stuff, but not like him.
Well, one time it was you. I know it was you, and you had the puppet, and you pecked me in the head with it and hurt my eye. So we got words up in the parking lot, brother.
This one time when I was 7, you told me. This whole event was really orchestrated.
Yeah.
This one time the ride was like this, and you changed it and raped my childhood.
Actually, the Imagineer, Larry Nicolai, an old friend of mine from Magic Mountain. We worked together at Magic Mountain, and now he's one of the great Imagineering gods. And we hadn't seen each other in a long time. We had lunch together in L.A., and before he sat down, he said, "I have to tell you something. I'm sorry for what we did. You're right." Because he was part of the team that
redid it,
and it, you know that it was never meant to look like that.
Yeah.
It was never meant to look like that. It's just that's what happens when people start pulling budgets apart and mixing things and stuff like that.
And then he killed himself.
Yeah. I told him to.
I told him to. You know what? Just kill yourself.
Was that the guy with the shotgun?
when we did the 40-hour broadcast for Lou Magello.
Yeah.
And one of the things he videotaped, and I'm hoping we'll put it up online, was we went through the ride now with me and Lou sitting behind me. The whole train was filled with fans, and I'm sitting in the very first front seat of the first car with three little kids, a couple of kids, and we pulled into the first room of the ride, and I said very loudly, I said, "Now you all notice the first room of the ride used to be this wonderful scene, we're flying along, and the Dreamfinder tells you that we all have an imagination. And now we're here in front of a machine that's going to tell us we don't have any imagination." And then we went through the ride, and I'm pointing straight out to them. And we get to the last room of the ride, just before they say, they have the big explosion, there's this quiet moment. And I turned to the kids and I said, "So kids, what have you learned today?" And all three kids went, "Nothing!"
The editing host freaked out because he's afraid that Disney is going to sue us using that image, and I kept telling him it's free publicity to try. So, anyways,
like a year ago.
That's awesome.
The year is 1979. B. Carr Walker says we're going to build this.
It's the geodesic sphere.
Yeah. Who said geodesic sphere? Micah, thank you.
Very welcome.
Good.
Thank you so much.
On this page, I want you to sign it two times.
Nice.
And write whatever you want.
Literally,
to Kyle, go F yourself in real life.
I'm gonna cry. Pretty cool, huh? Very, very cool.
Done.
Keep dreaming. That's class. That's class.
Creation, right at the start of everything that's new. The little spark lights up to you in the world of laughter.
No. Sing one little spark.
All right, ready?
That's the
yeah.
One, two, three, four.
One little spark of operation.
Help! Please! Get me out of here!
Come through with your fast spark from me and you.
We're gonna watch this one, right?
Play the entire
run. I know.
Now better. We're going to land.
50 verses. Wonderful meeting all of you. Thank you so much for inviting me. It's been wonderful.
Yeah. Right at the start of everything that's new.
He's still doing it. One little spark.
Bye, guys.